guys, Dave here with a new riff for you to try out. Today we're going to look at It's Only Love by Bryan Adams and Tina Turner. One of my favourite riffs, got some great chord voicings in it, some nice cut-offs, and a little sliding lick in between. Okay guys, I hope you enjoy this one. Now let's have a close-up. Okay, first chord is a D5 with an A in the bass. I'm holding down the 3rd fret on the B, 2nd on the G, and then the open D and A strings together. I'm also going to mute off the other strings, so the back of the 3rd finger is going to choke off the open 1st string, and I use my thumb to choke off the open 6th string. That way I can hit all the strings, only hear the chord that I need to. Like that. Okay, that's the first chord, and then it's followed by a rest on beat 2, or the first half of beat 2. Like that, just put the palm on the strings to cut it off. Then we change to a C sus2, keep the 3rd finger on the B string, play the open G, and we're playing the 3rd fret on the A. And again, we're going to allow the back of the fingers to choke off the other strings. Then cut that off on beat 4. Then we're going to play an A sus 4, so keeping the 3rd finger on the B string again, and then I'm going to bar across frets 2 on the G and D strings, and we're playing the open A. Like that. So you'll notice the first 3 chords have this 3rd fret on all the way through. And after the A sus 4, cut that one off as well. Then we're going to play a B flat 5. That's 1st fret on the A, 3rd on the D, 3rd on the G. Then we get this little slide. Slide from 3 to 5 on the A string. Then play 3 on the D. Then we're going to play the open D and A strings together. And then we're going to get a little kind of a muted up strum. Basically what's happening is he's going to move to the next chord, but he's not quite holding it down yet, and you end up with like a little muted up strum. So the next chord is going to be an F5. It's going to look like a normal barred F. So you bar across all 6 strings on the 1st fret, then you're going to hold down the 3rd fret on the A, 3rd on the D, and then normally you would hold down the 2nd fret on the G string, but what we're going to do is not hold it down, we're just going to mute it off by using the 2nd finger. And if you do that, you end up with a very wide sounding F5 power chord, which is what he's doing. And the way he plays the chord, he goes down, then up, cuts off the chord, does a muted up strum, and then 2 downs. Like that. And he does that sequence twice. I should also mention that once he's played it, he's cutting it off again. A big part of the whole riff actually is cutting off these chords in between. Okay, that's the riff. Okay, sound-wise, he's got a crunch guitar sound with a little bit of chorus and reverb on it. I'm using a Pod HD400 for this, and I've got it set on a Fender Deluxe amp model, and it's slightly overdriven. I've got a Tube Screamer in front of it as well, just to give it a little extra drive. I've got an analog chorus on it and a plate reverb to give it that sort of sound. So that's basically the sound he's got, slightly overdriven, lightly chorused and reverbed. Something else I think about with this riff that I think why it works so well is that he's got this kind of, there's the first 3 chords have got this common note in them. They've got this this high D. So the first three chords have got that, and I think it kind of acts to kind of glue the whole thing together. It's a nice little touch. You get similar ideas in songs like Wonderwall by Oasis, that sort of thing. So really nice. You've got the little slide. And then just kind of that nice kind of choppy rhythm that he's got. Actually, getting back to that, I think another nice thing I like about this is you've got those cut-offs in between the chords, so it really makes it sound punchy. So, and also, because it's not hugely overdriven, it's much easier to kind of get those nice, clear, crisp cut-offs in between the chords. There you go. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the lesson, and I'll see you for one real soon.